We're set for 3x5. The Chinese martial artist towers over the Malaysian, but the Malaysian is built, and he hits an early right hand. Shayed Shah with a quick shot, high knees. Muay Thai stylings early from the Chinese martial artist.
Now he cut him with the left hand, drops him. And Chow gets in nice and tight with a single leg, but Marcelinas is still hammering on that right hand.
Amethyst tries to the side of the head here from Mark Marcelinas after wobbling Shayed Shah with a looping right hand. Takedown here from Shayed Shah. Explosive start to this contest. Takes the back now. No, slides on out. Marcelinas on top. Will he allow Shayed Shah back up to his feet? And the Bornean Tiger does. What an explosive 45 seconds so far.
Chow looks a little bit hesitant now to engage with some of those wild strikes. Marcelinas was unloading in the first 30 seconds of the fight.
Marcelinas' hands are very low, particularly when he wades in with those looping punches. But he'd be careful of the counter down the tube from the very long-ranging Shay Chow.
No going.
This is where Chow wanted to get. He's got double overhooks now. Marcelinas has got double underhooks. Usually this means a takedown is coming. Knee tap, Marcelinas looks like he's going for a Kimura on the left side there.
Gets
it deep, oh, there it is!
Marcelinas taps out. Shayed Shah gets the victory. And for Mark Marcelinas, there is still no luck in the ONE Championship ring.
Oh, he got that. Once he got that Kimura lock, he knew that was it. He jumped guard, falls back, starts cranking on the Kimura, and Marcelinas had no place to go but to tap himself out. Big debut from Shayed Shah.
Shayed Shah said he wanted to have an explosive finish, and certainly the young Chinese martial artist did just that. Have a look the way he gets the arm here of Marcelinas and taps out the Malaysian.
Gets the Kimura in. Marcelinas tries to finish the takedown, and you can just see Jay Chow releases the arm, gets it nice and high. Perfect technique as he tries to crank the arm. Beautiful submission win for Jay Chow to mark his arrival to the featherweight division here in Shanghai.
Okay, let's go to Dominic Lau to put it in the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this fight after 1 minute and 28 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of Kimura, Shayed Shah!
Ready, go!
Li Qingqiao in the black and red, the all-black trunks here on Zheng Ziahao.
Zhao immediately marches forward, throws some nice combination of his hooking the straight right together.
Zhao controlling center cage at the moment. Looks at the inside leg, there's Li Qingqiao. Just a filling up process inside the opening 30 seconds. Two punch combination there from Zheng Ziahao.
Zhang drops his hands just slightly when he throws that lead hook. It'll be interesting to see what happens with Lee if he picks that up and throws that straight right down the middle.
There's the straight right indeed, and he catches it with it. Li Qingqiao sensing an opportunity, storms across the cage. Oh, smack bang to the nose there. Beautiful right hand from Li Qingqiao. And he's showboating, and the crowd is enjoying it.
Definitely getting overconfident a little bit there, letting the dance moves go.
They call him the Superboy, and he gets tapped twice with a nice left hook from Zheng Ziahao. Zheng Ziahao has the height and reach, and Li Qingqiao's got to be careful of those counter punches. Good jab two combination from Zheng Ziahao.
We should forget about the dancing push forward when he has Zhang hurt. Now Zhang's getting a little bit of confidence back, landing that double left hook, pushing forward.
Zheng Ziahao controlling center cage again. Li Qingqiao not showboating as he was 30 seconds ago after taking the power in the hands of Zheng Ziahao.
Fight!
Left hook, right hook combination there from Zheng Ziahao. Beautiful side kick, almost an outside crescent kick, and a jumping front kick from Li Qingqiao. Certainly has the acrobatics, the man with the peroxided hair.
He's landing some nice shots, but he's just not taking advantage of them. Once he has Lee hurt, or once he has Young hurt, he kind of backs off and celebrates a bit.
Interesting to note here that dangerously so, Li Qingzhao is competing with his mouth open. You want to be biting down on your mouth guard here. The more the mouth is open, the more open you are to being knocked out.
Just swivels that head around so fast, it leaves your jaw at a weakness. You gotta close that mouth.
Should have followed through with the right hand perhaps there. Outside crescent kick again from Li Qingzhao. Zhang Zhihao still looking to stamp his authority in the center of the cage, though he backs up now. Front kick to the thigh, misses the target for Li Qingzhao. Linking heavily on that left eye, he might have tasted it. Right hand there from Zhang Zhihao. Intriguing opening round. We are set from 3 by 5. Outside leg kick from Li Qingzhao.
He's got a bit of looks like he's kind of trying to counter strike. He waits for Zhang to come in and then he counters with a looping strike. Zhang's pushing forward, controls the center of the cage quite well. Just not moving forward, but he's dropping his hands every time he's throwing punches.
The confidence that Li Qingzhao had in the opening 90 seconds seems to have dissipated here. Good extension on the jab there from Zhang Zhihao. He's back to controlling center cage. Li Qingzhao trying to find a way on the inside, flicks up that half side kick, half outside crescent kick again. He's used it extensively, but to no real threat here.
He caught him the first time he threw it, but after that, Zhang seems to kind of get the distance and kind of evades it quite well. Now he's going to the body with it.
Outside leg kick from Li Qingzhao. Zhang Zhihao comes forward, looping hands again.
Just kind of grabbing the back of the head and sort of dirty boxing there a little bit when they get close to each other.
Beautiful right hand there from Zhang Zhihao. And Li Qingzhao forced it back up, and he tasted the power of that right hooking punch.
No fingers.
Finch now. Body shots from Zhang Zhihao.
The minute these guys get close, they just start wailing on each other.
Well, Li Qingzhao can take a knock, that's for sure. Under 30 seconds remaining, opening round. A good one, I feel, for Zhang Zhihao.
He had success in the opening round. He celebrated a bit prematurely. And now Zhang started to taunt him a little bit, saying he's got nothing on him.
Left hook, long, looping left hook there from Zhang Zhihao. He's had good ring control. He's had the aggression. And he'll round out a very solid opening round for Zhang Zhihao. Rich Franklin, how do you analyze that opening stance? It was the showboating and the aggression early on from Li Qingzhao. But then after that, it seemed to be Zhang Zhihao who dominated.
Yeah, I thought Li Qingzhao came out and established control at the beginning of this round. And I think he did enough, actually, for me at this 5-point mark in the match to be winning at this point. Zhang Zhihao, towards the end of the match, was able to, you could see the combinations landing from the clinch here. And I believe the momentum is switching to his direction. We're going to see this coming up in the second round. But at this point in time, if the match was stopped, I would give the decision to Li Qingzhao.
Rich, from a judge's point of view, does the showboating like we saw from Li Qingzhao early play any effect on the judging here?
It shouldn't play anything into the judges. You know, I'm sitting here, much like the judges around the cage are, notating the things that I see that are scoring. Kicks landing, punches landing, whatever, cage control it may be. And I'm taking note of that. The moment that somebody backs up and does a little bit of showboating, it may be great for the crowd, but I really don't pay any attention to it.
Second round set for 3. An interesting contest indeed between Zhang Zhihao in the all black and Li Qingzhao in the black and red. Good stiff left hand there from Zhang Zhihao. Fakes from Li Qingzhao. Goes to the outside lead thigh, misses the target. No switching stance between these two men. They've both competed at orthodox and seem very comfortable there.
Zhang's not really thrown any kicks. The only thing he's thrown is hands. So he's only given Li one weapon to worry about. But Li's mixing it up, going from the body to the head and also to the legs as well. So he's a little bit more diverse in his attack.
Will we see that side kick from Li Qingzhao that he so heavily favored in the opening round. Looks at that outside lead thigh again, then goes to the inside lead thigh. Yuji Shimada wants to see some more action in. Now Li Qingzhao responds with a straight right cross. Counter right there, fell short, really pulled it back on that occasion, Li Qingzhao.
Now Li's starting to add a little bit more to his punches, putting these things together, not worrying about entertaining the crowd, but moving forward and landing shots. And he's being, his superior strikes are landing with much more authority.
Interestingly, both men did predict they'd win by ground and pound, though we haven't seen any real attempts to get this contest on the ground so far. Li Qingzhao did say ground and pound in any of the three rounds. Zhang Zhe's power was a little more specific. He did say the first round, though, that opportunity has passed him by.
He likes to leap in with these strikes or the Superman punch, but he's really not setting it up. If he throws a leg kick and then fakes the leg kick and jumps in, he might have a little bit more success.
Southpaw stance now from Zhang Zhehao. First time we've really seen him sitting there for more than a few seconds. Now he switches back to his preferred orthodox and back to southpaw. So Zhang Zhehao switching stance here in the second round, maybe hoping to confound and put off the rhythm of Li Qingzhao.
Zhang does have a Taekwondo background, but he's not really showing it with the kicks. He's showing it more with the stance. He's got that wide base, and he's moving back and forth. But he's predominantly just boxing. Now he's pushing forward. The exchange.
Left hook catches Li Qingzhao in another one. Li Qingzhao's hands are down. And Zhang Zhehao making him play another left hook. Smack bang on the kisser. And Li Qingzhao counts his teeth. He's on rubber legs now. Still a long time to go here in the second round. Left hook again. There's the overhand right. And another thunderous overhand right from Zhang Zhehao.
Look at the patience of Zhang. Waiting, picking his shots. Lighting Li up as Li dives in for a takedown. Gets stopped. He gets thrown a knee for his trouble.
Knee between the eyes. Gets backed up now. Confidence flowing on Zhang Zhehao. Li Qingzhao has taken some big blows here in the second round. He lunges forward, overextends. Gotta watch out for the counter strikes. Left hook again, backs him up. Li Qingzhao in trouble here. He's slowed right down, really struggling now. Can Zhang Zhehao find the finish?
Big heart from Li, but Zhang, I think the knockout is there for him. If he just jumps on Li, he can get it.
Li Qingzhao looks ripe for the picking. 120 remaining in the second round of three. Li Qingzhao is hurt. He's very flat-footed. But Zhang Zhehao, showing patience, wants to be methodical.
Did Zhang gas himself out by throwing those bombs at Li? Is he tired here? Or is he just patient, picking his shot?
What do you think, Rich Franklin? Has he tired himself out here, Zhang Zhehao?
I don't think so. I think he's just being very patient with this. A mistake, in my opinion. He had Li Qingzhao wobbly legs, and he should have taken advantage of that.
Is it an opportunity he will rue having missed? Zhang Zhehao, as the ringside position takes a look at Li Qingzhao.
Li's sitting down a little bit as the doctor is checking him out, making sure he's fit to continue. He might be hurt.
If he can go on here, let's see if Zhang Zhehao will pounce on him. It looks like indeed Yuji Shimada is about to get us back underway. Still plenty of time for Zhang Zhehao to find a finish in this round, but maybe that momentum he had about a minute and a half, 2 minutes ago is gone. He squandered the opportunity to finish Li Qingzhao.
Go!
Now the gas tank is going to come into play. Who has the better conditioning to push forward? Can Li come back and mount a comeback? Or will Zhang jump on him and finish this contest?
Zhang Zhehao switching stance again between his preferred orthodox and southpaw. Using his reach well, that lead hand has been a treat to watch. Certainly, if you were scoring round by round, this one has to go to Zhang Zhehao.
Zhang really is throwing that heavy left hook. If he answers, if he throws that straight right, I believe it's right there.
Li Qingqiao trying to steal some points in the closing portion of this round. Oh, just thrust him against the cage. A late left hook there. A very solid round for Zhang Zhihao.
Good contest so far. Lots of back and forth action. I think you can see there's that Superman punch. Naked, didn't come with a setup. Zhang turns him around and lets the hands go. Here's that flurry. Starts off with the jab, connects with the hook, and then starts throwing that overhand right like he's tossing baseballs into the crowd. Unloads. Rich, did anything change in that fight, or did Zhang just continue to extend his lead?
No, Zhang Zhihao, he's very dangerous either from the clinch or when you're in close. I mean, that's where he gets very dangerous. He starts throwing these punches, and they just come like a blender has been turned on. Listen, I have Li Qingqiao actually scored not only in the striking superior category in the first round, but he also scored in damage. However, Zhang Zhihao in the second round there scored in the damage category as well. I believe that what he did with his striking combos and the striking superiority in that round was enough to actually overtake the discrepancy after the first round. I have him winning after two rounds.
Third and final round between Li Qingqiao and Zhang Zhihao. Very strong second round for Zhang Zhihao. Let's see what the Superboy can do to try and swing the pendulum back here in the third and final.
Very close right here. Can Superboy turn it on? Nice stiff jab from Zhang.
That lead hand has been exceptional for Zhang Zhihao. And Li Qingqiao just loses his footing in a vital moment.
Two slips. I think both guys slipped. Kind of evens the playing field a bit. That jab. Oh, I like that. It's landed over and over again.
Fast, it's precise, it's long. And again from Zhang Zhihao. Li Qingqiao's got to find a way getting the inside of the left hand. Overcome the reach advantage of Zhang Zhihao.
Or at least move his head. Can't just keep his head in one position. He's got to get his head moving. It's just a stationary target at this time that Zhang has been lighting up.
We've been seeing what he has to offer. Outside thigh kick attempt there from Li Qingqiao. Not near the target though. You feel that Li Qingqiao needs to put the foot down and really start working here in the third and final. Or time may become his enemy. Good left hook there from Zhang Zhihao. It's all about that lead hand again for Zhang Zhihao.
Puts these punches together. Now he's just kind of throwing one at a time. He's throwing one jab, he's throwing one straight right hand, one hook. If he puts these punches together, I believe we could see a finish, but there's some fight in Li.
You can see the handiwork with which Zhang Zhihao competed in pro boxing in the Hunan province for 4 years. Certainly coming to the fore here tonight.
No fingers, fingers, no. Grip, grip.
Li Qingqiao, I feel Rich Franklin really needs to get a move on now.
Definitely, I think Zhang Zhihao has increased his lead here. He's doing a great job with the jab. It's the straightest punch that he throws, and occasionally he'll do an excellent job landing that right hand, but really he needs to tighten that thing up and throw it straighter, just like that jab right there, and he'll put this match away much faster.
Mitch, that jab really is exquisite to watch.
Just like a fencer, it's coming in so fast. He lunges in and he pops right back out. And it's also coming from a different angle. See how he keeps his left hand low by his hip? Oh, nice right hand.
Smack bang to the side of the jaw there from Zhang Zhihao.
Zhang has so much more success when he puts his punches together in bunches. He lands on the second and third punch.
Two punch combination, double jab to a left hook. It's all Zhang Zhihao now. And Li Qingqiao is in trouble. Yuji Shimada moves in, and it's over. A TKO victory for Zhang Zhihao, and a game predictably via the hands of the boxer.
Nice finish to get it late in the third. Beautiful hands put together by Zhang. We've got a new lightweight announcing his arrival in ONE Championship. Look at this. Beautiful lead answers with the right. Again, just unloading on Li. Yuji Shimada saw enough, jumped in. Look at these hands. Crisp, clean, boxing. late in the third, puts it together, gets a big win in Shanghai.
Certainly a popular victory by Zheng Zhuhao. The handiwork just too good for Li Chengchao. Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Yuji Shimada has put a stop to this fight after 2 minutes and 53 seconds in the third and final round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Zheng Zhuhao.
Who will look the takedown attempt first? The shorter, lower center of gravity on Mona Samir.
Mona Samir has a lightning fast double and it comes out of nowhere too. Now Jay gets nice and tight with the clinch, ties up the hands, sort of drags this contest right into the cage, presses her up against the cage. Now she might be looking for a guillotine. Oh, she jumps to the back.
Taking the back of Mona Samir early here, trying to get those hooks in, is Miao Zhang.
Looks like she's threatening for a possible crucifix position. She might be going after an arm here.
Oh, she tapped her up. Just like that, she tapped her up. Supermom with a super win indeed. Miao Zhang brings the house down here in Shanghai.
Yeah, looked like she got on top, had the back, looked like she was threatening for an arm bar. Got into a bad position for Mona Samir. And once she had that arm extended, you can just see it from that angle right there, that was it. She had nowhere to go. Look at this. So Mona Samir's defending well, has her hands clasped together, but the minute Miao Zhang releases that grip, just right about there, yeah, it extends the arm and just craps. It might be a wrist lock underneath there. She's got it nice and tangled up here, has that arm pinched, is able to separate the arms using her leg and her hands. Very effective break. Still can't quite see it, but I think it's possibly a wrist lock. I don't think she had the arm fully extended.
Either way, a superb victory for Superman Miao Zhang. Very quick to finish Mona Samir. Samir began aggressively looking for a takedown. But once it went to ground, Miao Zhang tied her up and tapped her out, Mitch.
Looked like it was a chicken wing there. We saw it better from that angle. She got it from the Kimura.
Let's go to Dominic Lau, and indeed we'll find out exactly how it ended.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee Olivier Coste has put a stop to this contest after 49 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of armbar, Miao Zhang!
It's a riddle that Muhammad's got to solve, and he's got to solve it fast. We're set for three rounds. Yuji Shimada, our referee. Sagatalpit Payatai in Southpaw starts. If he clinches with Mahmoud Muhammad, that's the real strength of Sagatalpit Payatai.
If you can, you avoid playing tennis. Yes, you get nice and close and you take this fight to the ground as quickly as possible. Now we get to see how good the takedown defense of the legendary Papayatai truly is.
Papayatai predicted a knee to the head would end this contest. Mahmoud Muhammad said he'll submit the Thai with a rear naked choke. To do so, he's got to get him down and he's got to take Papayatai's back. You don't want Papayatai to lock on that Muay Thai clinch. It's like a vice. If he locks it on Muhammad, it could drive the knee to the ribs, drive the knee to the jaw.
Beautiful redirection by Papayatai. Once he got that clinch, he spun Mahmoud around.
Good work by Mahmoud to get back to his feet here. Presses Papayatai against the cage. Elbow from Papayatai.
Oh, the big cover! It's not that Irene! Or is it? Referee says continue. Papayatai thought he had him knocked out.
And now he'll look for the finish. But will he go to ground with Muhammad? It was a huge elbow. The drop. The man from Cairo.
Breaks, breaks.
And Yuji Shimada allows Muhammad back up. He's in trouble though. Here comes Papayatai. Here come the elbows. Oh, he knocks him again. Muhammad's on the legs. And now it's over. Sagatalpit
If you go back just a little bit in that video, we will see one of the nastiest walk-off elbows we've ever had in one championship. There's the this is the barrage that happened just before, but what a beautifully timed elbow. Spun him around, found a hole, sliced through the guard. This was the end right here. This is just before Yuji Shimada stopped it, but what a beautiful elbow.
Mitch, like you said, you don't play tennis against Federer. You don't run against Usain Bolt. You don't stand in elbow range against Sagatow Patpayattai, a four-time Lumpini champion.
He got hit with a stick of dynamite. That was amazing.
Let's go to Dominic Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 41 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, Sagatow Patpayattai.
Let's go.
He says, look out for the head kick. That's how it's going to happen. Both men here in southpaw stance. Outside leg kick, a nice one from Rozeski. Ripping roundhouse kick to the ribs there from Yamada, and Rozeski with the early takedown. Roll through there from Rozeski, looking for a submission on the knee. Couldn't get it. Tries to put Yamada inside the guard, has one butterfly hook on the left leg.
Look at the guard here. Now we get to see what Rozeski's like off his back. He's got that half guard, keeps the guard nice and high on that left side. He's very active off his back. He says he likes to throw up the triangle from all positions. But look at the way Yamada slices through it. Can he maintain the top position? Rozeski scrambling.
Rozeski back to his feet. And we've got ourselves a striking contest again. Rozeski said he'd win via triangle. 10 of his wins in his career have come via triangle. As we said, look out for Yamada's head kicks. There's one off the back leg. Bork left hand drives Rozeski back against the fence. Rozeski looks for underhooks. Nice corking knee to the inside thigh from the American.
Nice. I like how Yamada has that deep underhook, transitions right into a single, tries to take the back, but ends up in mount.
Second time Yamada's mounted him, takes the back of Rozeski. Gonna look for a rear naked choke. Yamada's setting for it. Body triangle, figure four slapped on. That'll constrict the breathing of Rozeski. It'll make him hard to take a full lung of air. Striking from the back here, Yamada. Is this a bad predicament for Rozeski here, Mitch?
Yeah, this is a bad spot because it's really hard for him to turn. You can see he's trying to hold the wrist on the right side there, trying to spin, but the body triangle is so tight there, it's preventing him to. Now he's got the choke in.
Yamada with the choke. Can he find the finish? Yamada locks out moisture, seals it.
Beautiful rear naked choke. I don't even think he was fully under the chin. That's how tight his choke is.
Tetsuya Yamada knew that Rozeski was a strong grappler, but out-grappled him here tonight. This the beginning of the end. The takedown from Rozeski got back to his feet. Once the figure four was locked on, though, Mitch, only a matter of time.
Yeah, he got under the chin there, nice and tight. Rozeski tried to fight it off, but it was inevitable. Just nice and tight with the rear naked choke. Rozeski had no place to go. Forcefully tapping on the back of Yamada's head there to relieve some of that pressure, but just look how tight that is.
The Kempo black belt didn't get the chance to throw the Kempo strikes in the stand-up on the ground after a six-week camp. Yamada proving too good. Let's go to Dominic Lau to enter it into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 55 seconds in the first round. For your winner, by way of rear naked choke, Tetsuya Yamada!
Boxing versus Kunkumai. Which striking art will come up trumps tonight? Ayanut in the green. Shu Chonyan, the blue, red, and white. A little fake there early from the boxer. Both women in orthodox stance. Look out for the left hook, straight right cross combination here on Xu Chongyan. Just a feeling out process inside the opening 35 seconds. Tremendous amount of respect for both of these warriors. They know the high level of experience and the championships each have won in their respective sports. There's the right hand, there's the left hook early from Xu Chongyan. And a takedown from the boxer, side control. We may see some of that BJJ training coming to play.
Heavy hips from Yanut to stay on top. Now she's got the headlock defense. She's got to be careful she doesn't give up her back. She's not letting go of that head at all, but it leaves her open to have that back taken.
What's up? Round and pound through the back here from Xu Chongyan. No Brazilian jiu-jitsu experience on AUNF. It's all striking for her. Her trainer, Chun Reach, telling us BJJ non-existent in Cambodia. And she's looking to get flattened out here. Xu Chongyan's got the hooks in. She's setting up for a rear naked choke. But at the moment, Ayanut defending and defending well.
Ayanut's got to turn onto her back. She can't stay there. She's going to get grounded, pounded out. She's got to turn. She's got to fight. Oh, that's exactly it. Get on top.
Top position now for Ayanut. Is she going to allow the world boxing champion to her feet? And indeed she does. They're back to center cage. A thrilling contest. 2 minutes down in the opening round. And the crowd loving it. Massive crowd inside the Shanghai Oriental Sports Center. Wherever you're watching, 128 countries around the world, we hope you're enjoying One Championship Shanghai.
Action!
Fake again there from Xu Chongyan. She'll look to plant that right hand on the kisser of Ayanut. Ayanut does not want to go to ground. She may want to get in close, negate the boxing of Xu Chongyan and work the knees, work the elbows from the clinch. Kun Kamai, like Muay Thai, has a very strong clinch game. There's a right hand threaded from Xu Chongyan. Ayanut also showing a right hand of her own. I'm going to change levels a little there, Xu Chongyan. Just fakes and feints for the world champion boxer.
Yanut needs to push forward. She needs to start putting combinations together. Looks like Xu's getting nice and comfortable throwing out that jab, getting her timing down, her reach. Yanut's got to push forward. She's got to create some kind of movement, get Xu a little bit more distracted.
Watch when Xu Chongyan throws the leg kick. What she does first is does a little fake, a little shimmy with her hands to distract Ayanut and then slings the leg to the lead thigh of the Cambodian. Jab two coming perhaps here from Xu Chongyan. Very loose with that lead hand, the boxer. Loves to shoot out that jab. Likes the right hand for company. And Olivia Costa wants more action from both these ladies. You see the very different stance, the different types of guards on both of these athletes. The more boxing guard, of course, of Xu Chongyan. The Kun Kamai, very similar to the Thai guard, Ayanut. Overhand right from Ayanut, trying to land it on top of the brains of Xu Chongyan. Just resets herself, body shot from Xu Chongyan, changing levels, nice to see. That's good, sounds good. Ayanut does a quick count of her teeth.
You just see Xu's getting a lot more relaxed. She's throwing out that leg kick. She's distracting Ayanut. And Ayanut looks to be a little bit tentative. She's not quite letting her strikes go the way that she normally does. She's got to push forward. Xu's getting very relaxed. Her hands are even starting to come down.
Quite surprised. We haven't seen many kicks here from Ayanut, especially to the leg of Xu Chongyan. One way to slow down the boxer is to kick out the legs. But it's actually Xu Chongyan who's throwing more kicks than Ayanut here in the first round.
Time.
We go to the towels. Not a lot in that opening round of action. Both women really feeling each other out. Of the salvos, though, you feel that Xu Chongyan probably got the better of the exchanges.
Yeah, in that exchange, you see that Xu Chongyan was able to get her to the ground, get on top, and see Yanut giving up the arm, their possible armbar takedown, but this has been the story of this fight. The exchanges, Xu is controlling and dictating what is happening here. She's throwing out that leg kick and landing with some punches. Rich, how did you have that?
Yeah, Yanut has really not done a whole lot to score in that round. Maybe off of a couple clinches, she's landed a few combos, like a 3-2 combination there towards the end of the round. But Xu Chaoyan is pretty much being the aggressor, dictating the pace, landing more strikes, both with the kicks and the punches as well. She's just tighter on the punches and first to actually land. At this point in time, I have her head on the scorecards for sure.
Seconds out. Second round of three. In front of a massive crowd inside the Oriental Sports Center in stunning Shanghai. If you've never visited this city before,
ready?
Put it on your bucket list.
Let's go!
Second of three. Boxing champion, Xu Chaoyan. Kun Kamai champion, Yanut. Looking front, kick off the back leg there, just testing the waters from Xu Chaoyan. Yanut needs to look to work rate, good two-punch combination. Second one to the solar plexus from Xu Chaoyan. Advancing right hand. There's finally a high kick from Yanut, and there's the knee. Tries to put the head down and make the drink.
With the headlock, and Yanut's trying to take her back, but Yanut is the one that gets back up to her feet, has the double underhooks, and lands a knee on the exit.
Heads exposed here. The right knee could come up from Yanut. Can she get some balance on her left leg and throw it? She does, but it's to the thigh of Xu Chaoyan. Dropping her body weight down cleverly here, Xu Chaoyan throws a knee of her own. Both women trade in the knees. Single-handed clinch from Yanut, throws a corky knee to the upper right thigh, then switches to the left thigh. Good knees in the clinch here from Yanut, putting down the points, staying busy. And again, the Cambodian. Little scooping bolo punch into the midsection. Driving knee again to the top of the left thigh from Yanut. Much better showing, 1 minute 35 down in the second round.
Go work!
Yanut, now she's starting to push the jab action here right now. But she's got that headlock and she's not letting that go. So Lydia Cost is forced to separate the two. And now you see Yanut's chance to start swinging this round into her favor.
We asked Yanut's trainer, Chan Reach, about her mindset coming in and the game plan. And he said, Kun Kamai, it's hit first and ask questions later. Can she beat Xu Chaoyan to the punch, to the kick, to the knee here? Xu Chaoyan goes to the body, backs out nicely, in and out movement. Clever work here from Xu Chaoyan. Counter hooks from Xu Chaoyan. I feel that Yanut still hasn't found her rhythm here, Mitch. Still hasn't been able to set that metronome.
She's still kind of fighting off the back foot. She's waiting for Xu to initiate the exchange, and then she's reacting. She's not pushing forward. She's not marching forward the way she usually does with heavy shots, and she's not even setting up those kicks.
Surprises me also that Yanut is allowing Xu Chaoyan to turn this into a boxing match. Whereas Yanut should be trying to turn it into more of a kickboxing match. Work those kicks, go to the inside, work the clinch, work the knees, work the strong hand.
Big right hand is her best punch. It's landing right over the lead hand of Yanut, and it's connecting.
And they're back against the cage here. Yanut better drift back to center cage. Or she'll be target practice. Body shot there from Xu Chaoyan. The round started well for Yanut, but Xu Chaoyan seems to have swung the tide more in her favor over the last 60, 70 seconds. Shimmy of the hand again there from Xu Chaoyan before she connected with the leg kick. Here it goes again. And that time, she distracted with the right and threw the left down the tube. Clever contest so far from Xu Chaoyan. Faking levels now. Jab to right hand to the belly button. boxing coming to the fore again for Xu Chongyun, who had an 8-week training camp in prep for this one. 15 days of Phuket top team in Thailand to round it out. What should Ayanut be doing here, Mitch?
She has to push forward. She has to see how she's kind of letting Xu dictate how the distance is, but then she's also dictating where this fight is moving forward. There she is. She's distracting with that lead kick, and then she throws that overhand right. And there it is again.
If you ever saw Ayanut compete in Khun Khmer, she was known as a brawler. That's where she had most of her success, in brawling, in flailing, in catching her opponent. But she hasn't managed to turn this into a brawl. She's trying to have a technical contest, and it's just not working out against the more polished Xu Chongyun.
I think Xu's landing with the bigger shots, and it's kind of hurting Yanut's confidence. So she's not pushing forward the way that she normally should. Here's the clinch, the tie-up. She had a perfect chance, but Xu was able to headlock take Yanut down to the ground. And that's just kind of, that's been the story of the ground, is the battle of the headlocks. Here's that nice overhand right that connected right on the button of Yanut. And you can see Xu just kind of shimmies there. She knows she heard her. Rich, break that one down.
Yeah, listen, as you see, Ayanut is just sitting back, like you said, Michael, and she needs to initiate the attack if she wants to win this. Even when she's landing like a body kick, Xu Chongyun is still just landing that right hand hard. You saw the other right hand that she landed in the replay there. The way I see this, she's just extended her lead that much more. She's winning with the kicks, she's winning with the punches, she's winning on the ground. And I've also got her, I didn't mention this in the last round, scored in damage, because you can see the welt on Ayanut's face.
Third and final round, it looks all for Ayanut to do. In front of an incredible audience, inside the massive Oriental Sports Center in Shanghai. One championship, putting on a show. Ayanut needs to turn this into a brawl. She needs to pull out all the stops, throw caution to the wind.
More action, okay, ready? Ready?
Third and final. Immediately, you see Xu Chongyun confidently stride out of her corner to stamp her authority in the center of the ring. Probing inside leg kick there from Xu Chongyun. There's the right hand. Ayanut cannot afford to be on the back foot and as flat-footed as she is. Thought about switching stance there in the Cambodian. You just see the dominant position here of Xu Chongyun. Again, backs her up, straight right hand to the bread basket.
Go!
Fakes off both hands now, Xu Chongyun. And that one's flush to the nose. She's landing the right hand early here, Mitch.
Yeah, she's setting up really well. She throws that inside leg kick as just kind of a range finder. She steps forward and then just throws that right hand.
Xu Chongyun with a hook. And now Ayanut cuts forward. Can she find the brawl now? Jumping out the cage. Gut-munching knee from Ayanut. This is more like it from the Cambodian. Drives a knee to the top of the thigh. Looks to pull the head down.
Fence.
Olivier Coast right on top of the action, making sure neither combatant grips the cage. Takedown!
Chance to possibly finish this, but you can see that Yanut's kind of got that clinch position, and she's not going to let that go, because the minute Xu's able to pop her head up, she's going to start raining down those punches. But she's to let go of the head, push off the hips, and create some space to move.
Very high mount now from Xu Chongyun.
What to finish?
She could turn this into an arm. She's going to go for a ground and pound. Here comes Xu Chongyun. And Ayanut gets her back. Can Xu Chongyun tap her out? Can she find a rear naked choke? It would bring the house down in Shanghai. Very high back mount here from Xu Chongyun.
What the finish?
As we said, Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu non-existent in Cambodia, according to Chan Reach, the coach of Ayanut. How will she defend against the rear naked choke attempt here from Xu Chongyun?
Xu Chongyun's a bit high on the back, so it's going to be hard for her to sink that choke, and she doesn't quite have the leverage there. Yeah, she's got to readjust, scoot back down the back, but she gave Yanut a chance to get back up.
Now Ayanut in top position. position. Inside Shu Chun-Yun's closed guard. Can the Cambodian open that gap? Can she posture up and rain down the punches?
No holding, what?
Controlling the posture wisely here, Shu Chun-Yun. Maybe hoping for a referee stand-up from Olivier Coast.
See, Shu's kind of employing the same sort of defensive technique that Yanut was, just to keep the head close, avoiding that opponent from being able to posture up and rain down those shots.
And this is what Shu Chun-Yun was hoping for. Indeed, Olivier Coast breaks them.
Ready? Ready?
And the time is now her enemy. 1:45 remains in the third and final. Again, Shu Chun-Yun on the front foot. Right hand curls him over the top. There's a left hook from the Chinese woman. Knees on the inside from Ayunut. She's had some success, maybe her best success tonight, with the knees from the clinch. And a takedown, a side headlock there from Shu Chun-Yun. Really talking and applying pressure to that neck line of Ayunut. Ayunut all tied up with no place to go. And the mount again from Shu Chun-Yun. 1:05 remaining. It's all Shu Chun-Yun. The dominant position for the Chinese martial artist.
In the final round.
Push the hips down. She's got to create some space. Maybe let Shu Chun-Yun posture up so she can push the hips and start moving around. But now she's in a really bad spot. But she bridges out but gives up her arm in the process.
Armbar attempt! Armbar attempt from Shu Chun-Yun. Can she take it home? And now you're not trying to pound her way out. And indeed, she's out of danger.
Achilles lock here on the left leg of Shu, but she's got to extend her hips a little bit to create a little bit better angle. Go to the other leg. There she goes. Transition to the other one.
Shu Chun-Yun hoping for a sub in the final stages. We're going down to the wire on this one. Shu Chun-Yun and the fist strike, ground and pound, and the crowd here in Shanghai gives it up for Shu Chun-Yun.
Entertaining contest between two warrior female athletes. That last round was Yanut's best. She applied a lot more pressure. She even threatened a possible submission there. But here you just see more of the same, just the punches landed by Shu Chun-Yun. Here's the mount, Shu Chun-Yun. Again, you kind of see Yanut bridge out to the side, but she almost gifts wraps this arm bar for her in the process. You can see her extending the arm like that. Shu Chun-Yun could have snatched that up. Here's the headlock takedown from Shu Chun-Yun. Just muscles her down to the ground. Entertaining contest here in Shanghai. Rich, how did you have that one?
Well, Shu Chun-Yun just extended her lead in that round. You know, landed more right hands, landed the takedown, more ground control. But I got to give credit to Ayunut there at the end, just looking for a way to win this fight and actually sitting back with an ankle lock. So,
okay, let's go to Dominic Lau and find out who won.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we now turn to the scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. From the red corner, Shu Chun-Yun.
Amir Khan says Yaroslav is open to right crosses to the chest and solar plexus, followed by left hooks. Gartim says second round, ground and pound, TKO. Southpaw stance on 22-year-old Singaporean Amir Khan. Switching stance now to orthodox, threads that left hand nicely, and back to southpaw. High kick from Amir Khan. He's lengthy, he's precise, and he's fast. And he just nails Yartim with that left out of southpaw. Locks up the leg, can he hope for a driving takedown? Gets it on the check. Somersault backward there from Yartim. Front headlock here from Amir Khan. Drives the knees in. Nice work from the Singaporean. And they're back to their feet.
team defends with a wizard there, but look at Khan's strength. Just got that body lock. Now he's trying to muscle him back to the ground, but good work for our team. He's spin him around, but Khan gets control again because he has that underhook on the right side.
Yep. 8-week training camp for Amir Khan. 3-month camp for Yaroslav Yatim.
Hey!
Amir's corner telling him to keep the pressure on. Let's see if Yatim can exercise some of that speed that he said he'd need to beat Amir. And Amir beats him with a punch, the beautiful straight lift down the tube. Take down there from Amir Khan, doing everything right so far. Goes to side control. We'll look for a knee on belly here. Yatim looks to control the posture of the Singaporean. Where does Yatim need to go from here, Mitch?
He's got to move over onto his left side. He can't stay flat on his back like that. Khan's just got too much strength, too much pressure. But a big bridge by Hartim. But it doesn't allow him to change the position. It gets into actually a worse position here by giving up his back. Now Khan's working on both sides to get those hooks in. If he slides that left leg in, Hartim's going to be in a lot of trouble.
Amir Khan, 100% finishing rate. Only one has come by a submission. 6 by knockout. He's hoping to sub out Yaroslav Yatim right now. Still has the back of Yatim. Yatim trying to find a way to his feet. Not a predicament that the Czech wants to be in.
No gloves.
Trying to wrap the arm around the neck of Yatim. Showing a lot of patience here.
Half time.
Very methodical, Amir Khan. 2:15 remains in the first round. Fight. Both men swing with the hooks, neither connects. There's a shot to the chest that Amir Khan said that Yatim was open to. Southpaw now from Amir Khan. Yatim's got to beat Amir to the punch, to the kick. Two very big athletes in this division. Has the back standing now, does Amir Khan. Little back elbow just to let Amir know that he's here from Yaroslav Yatim.
You can see Khan is just one step ahead of him in every single one of these exchanges.
Whether it's
a grappling exchange or a clinch exchange, Khan's just moving a little bit faster. Now he's tried to change levels, but he separates out. Expect that left hand to come again.
That was nice work from Yatim. You saw Amir Khan drop levels to look for a double leg, and Yatim underhooked him, stood him back up.
Left hand is landing over and over again. Oh, and he faces
the big kabosh! The big kabosh! Amir Khan's done it! Smack bang! 100% finishing rate intact! Another first round finish for the stunning Amir Khan!
What a beautiful setup. He hit him again with the straight left hand through the high kick and then answered with a nice little right hook to put our team down. Beautiful finish. Let's take a look at that again. Boom, landed with the head kick. Boom, there's the right hand. Drops our team. Beautiful combination from the Singaporean Khan.
Amir Khan predicted a first round finish yesterday. He said the right hand would be one of the weapons it used, and certainly it's the one that did the job to finish Yaroslav Yatim. Let's go to Dominic Lau and make this knockout all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Fan Jianling, General Manager of Shanghai Just Sports Development Group. And now, your referee, Mr. Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 46 seconds in the first round for your winner by way of knockout, Amir Khan!
Let's go!
Most forecasts are that we won't go beyond 2. Southpaw stance on both of these athletes. Height and reach goes to Mahal Bin. Look at the build, though, on Hershey Getu. More muscles than a seafood platter. And he's circling clockwise early. Is the wolf of the grasslands.
He goes up.
High kick there from Mahal Bin. Probing with the lead hand here is Hershey Getu. 10-day camp for Mahaubin, 14 days for Hershey-Getu. Looks to catch and count with that right hand down the tube. Plenty of action early on here, Mitch.
That's a high-level Sandar move to catch that kick and answer immediately with those left hands.
Jab two from Hershey-Getu. High right roundhouse kick from Mahaubin. Mahaubin switching stance. Back to his preferred southpaw. Hershey-Getu looking to his corner there momentarily. And the smaller opponent get on the inside. He tries for that. Posting the leg here from Mahaubin. Once Hershey-Getu on his back. Hershey-Getu not going there. And gets free with a breaking right hook.
Nice takedown defense. Hershey-Getu as a high-level wrestler, Mahaubin. He's able to stop that takedown. So that's gotta increase his confidence.
Sellout crowd inside the Oriental Sports Center, certainly appreciative of the high-level martial arts we're seeing in the opening round. Flicking jab, probing left hand here from Hershey-Getu. He's in orthodox stance. Both men have been switched stances here in the opening match.
Yeah, and that's contributing to a lot of the different looks that these guys are showing, so it's hard to get a beat on your opponent when they're constantly changing stances.
Probing now from Mahaubin. Switches stance again. Shoots in for another single. It's a takedown, Mahaubin. Hershey-Getu momentarily threw the legs up, hoping to trap something. Mahaubin inside the guard now.
Fast Hershey-Getu is. Immediately when Mahaubin tries to get something, Hershey-Getu scrambling out. Now he's looking for a Kimura on that left side. Beautiful transitions from Hershey-Getu so far.
Both men did predict submission. They both said they'd come in the second round. Mahaubin said armbar. Hershey-Getu said rear naked choke. It's Mahaubin inside the guard of Hershey-Getu. 2:10 remaining in the first round. It's been a thriller so far. Hershey-Getu looking for a way to get back to his feet or maybe lock up that right arm.
Fishing for a Kimura on that right side, but I don't know if he's going to be able to get it because Mahaubin's got the body lock and he's so strong in that position. This is what we've seen from him. This is classic Mahaubin. Gets on top, controls and dominates his opponent. But we don't score just because you're on top. You don't win the round. Hershey-Getu slap on that Kimura attempt, and then you can see that Mahaubin was desperate to get out of that.
Hershey-Getu still has the full mount, and it's a high mount, high on the chest of Mahaubin. It'll also make it hard for Mahaubin to breathe. Hershey-Getu could switch around for an armbar attempt here. Going to line up the face of the ground and Mahaubin throws the arms up, controls the posture.
You gotta wonder, how often has Mahaubin, such a dominant wrestler, been put on his back and controlled in a mount position? Does he know what to do? Does he know how to get out of this compromising position?
If there's one place a wrestler doesn't want to be, it's on their back. Here's the ground and pound from Hershey-Getu. And Mahaubin gets it back. Can Hershey-Getu choke him out? No, Mahaubin back in top position. I've seen so many mount battles at this sellout crowd.
Unorthodox escape, but it did work. He was able to give up his back, transition back into the top position, and immediately Hershey-Getu is fishing for that Kimura.
Mahaubin escapes again. Hershey-Getu transition to submission time and time again. But Mahaubin more escapes than Michael Schofield here in the opening round, which is almost over. But not before Mahaubin gets off some ground and pound of his own. What a start to this contest, Mitch!
That was a prison break reference, but there's their kick. Immediately, Hershey-Getu catches the kick and starts throwing those left hands like jackhammers. Immediately, look at this beautiful single leg takedown from Mahaubin. But look at the scrambling. That's what you need to do. If you get taken down, you immediately need to keep moving. You need to start moving and scrambling to create that pattern. Look at this, here's that deep Kimura attempt. Mahalbin was in a lot of trouble. Tries to slam his way out of the Kimura, but it just gets deeper. Oh, Rich, how did you score that one?
I'll tell you what, this is a perfect round where I actually have Hoshigetu from the bottom winning the ground control category. He's more aggressive. He went for the Kimura. He was constantly working for things. Even if you just completely erase all the top position he had and he was only on the bottom, I would still score him as ground superiority winning there.
Do you give him a near submission in that Kimura attempt?
I actually awarded him a near submission. On top of that, I also have him winning the striking superiority category. Did a great job at the beginning of the round, catching that kick, landing a couple nice left hands. And he did a great job. Mahalbin, those shots, they're well-timed shots. And that first takedown defense was just an amazing takedown defense.
Terrific breakdown, as always, from Rich Franklin. Here we go, second round of three. Now, don't forget, this is the round which both athletes predicted they would finish this contest. Once again, Mahalbin said second round armbar. Hoshigetu said second round rear naked choke. Certainly the closer to a sub in the first was Hoshigetu. And again, both athletes switching stance, trying to confound each other, trying to disguise their attacks. Hoshigetu is just built. Look at the size of the deltoids and the traps on this little man from Inner Mongolia. Mahalbin, a long, lean, rangy beanpole. Fakes the back leg, fakes the left hand. Hoshigetu says, enough of that, I'll go down the center, double right. Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. If you're in Mahalbin's corner, what are you telling him to do?
I want to see him use that reach advantage that he has. I want to see him throwing out that jab to really just kind of distract and set up other shots or possibly big takedown attempts. But he's not really doing it. All he's doing is throwing that looping lead left hook, and it's not really even connecting.
Play coach now for Hoshigetu.
Hoshigetu, I like what he's doing. I want to see him push forward. I don't want to see him start allowing Mahalbin to get comfortable in the setup, the takedown. Mix things up, throw hands, put in leg kicks, really change what's taking place right now in this contest.
Both men showing a tremendous amount of respect for one another. Mahalbin told us yesterday, I really need to watch out for the takedowns of Hoshigetu. I'm not afraid of them. Nothing about Hoshigetu frightens me, but I know he's good on the takedown. That is good takedown defense from the wolf from the grassland. Muay Thai clean from Mahalbin, and he launches off with a right-legged roundhouse kick. Hoshigetu's been working with a boxing-specific coach. Improved his footwork dramatically, he said. And he try and close the distance with his punches, get the takedown, look for the opportunity to finish on the ground in this round. What are you seeing different from Hoshigetu in this round as to the first round, Mitch?
He's being a little bit more tentative. He's not really initiating the same way he was in the first round. In these exchanges, he's not really capitalizing the way that he should. His volume has significantly decreased, at least in the first 3 minutes of this round.
Inside leg kicks here from Mahalbin. Won't do a tremendous amount of damage, but just letting Hoshigetu know that he's here and letting him know that he's active. Christmas tree on the back there of Hoshigetu. My word, he is ripped, stripped, and striated. Wherever you're watching this, part of over 1 billion potential worldwide audience, 128 countries on our global telecast. We hope you're enjoying history in the making. A sellout crowd for one championship Shanghai. Martial arts returns to the country from where it was born. Mahalbin very wary of the right hand and left hooks here of Hoshigetu. Goes to the outside lead thigh. Front kick there from Mahalbin off the back leg. Mahalbin in southpaw, Hoshigetu on this round in orthodox stance. Under a minute remaining now. Slower first round, slower second round, I should say, Mitch Hotfield, than the first.
Yeah, I think it comes down to the condition. This impressive physique that we're seeing from Hershey get to.
Go.
Those muscles eat up a lot of oxygen. And as explosive as he was in the first 5 minutes, that's gonna eat up so much energy, and he's not gonna be able to see how slowly that shot came.
Slow shot, he's gonna pay the price right here. Hammerfist strikes from Mahalbin. Hershey gets a locks onto a single, tries to switch to a double, and Mahalbin gets a takedown. He's gonna try and choke him out! 15 seconds remaining! Can he find the finish in the second? Yes! 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 Mahalbin! Second round submission of Hershey Getu! My word! The Southern Eagle does it again!
What an impressive guillotine submission win for Mahalbin here in Shanghai. That was textbook. You could see Hershey Getu started to slow. He started to not create such explosion in his shot. Look at this, has his head on the inside. He keeps transitioning, keeps fighting for that single leg. Mahalbin dropping the ground and pound.
Mitch, what was the cardinal mistake that Hershey Getu made that led to his demise?
He didn't defend. He wasn't defending that guillotine choke the way that he should. He has to fight those hands. Once Mahalbin got the guillotine in deep, there wasn't any weight distribution. He wasn't defending the correct way. And I think it was just fatigue that set in, and he wasn't able to properly defend the guillotine. And there you have it. It might not have been the armbar that you called, the armbar, but it was a second round submission victory.
Prophetic stuff here from 23-year-old Mahalbin. Let's go to Dominic Lau to enter this one into the record books.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have Yuan Lei, Vice President of Shanghai Media Group. And now, your referee, Olivier Coste, has put a stop to this match after 4 minutes and 50 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of guillotine, Mahalbin!
We're set for 5x5 for the ONE Championship welterweight title. Shoots in early for Spunky Ben Askren. Kadestam's got to prevent the takedown. Askren launches a knee. Shoots in again, double leg now from Askren, one of his strengths. Looks for a driving takedown. Kadestam looked on the ground, now he goes for a ride! Shakalaka! Planted him like a tree! And that's what Askren does. If Askren wants you down, Mitch, you're going down.
Yeah, once those hands clasp together, you know you are going for a ride. Now, this is where Ben Askren just excels. He gets on top of you, consistently transitioning from position to position. Look at him trying to drag him down and keep him down. Look how he laces that leg, Michael. Yep. That right there is high-level wrestling.
This is Askrenville. This is Askren Town. He's all over. Kadestam early. Posting up with that right arm, the Swede. But look how funky Ben Askren's got him bent in hard. Askren, total domination so far from the champion. The greatest wrestler in all of martial arts today, Funky Ben Askren. 1 minute 15 down, it's been one-way traffic. And Kadestam find a way back to his feet. He needs to get there to launch his strikes. Askren puts a hook in, gives up on that.
See how he's constantly trying to trap those legs. He's always lacing his legs around it. It's like grappling with Ben Askren is like swimming with a fishing net tied around your neck. You can't get away from him. You can't create any space. And in defense, when you're trying to defend against a grappler, you have to create space.
Full now, from Funky Ben Askren. He'll posture up and work the ground and pound. Kadestam may give up his back in a moment. High mount from Ben Askren. Measures him. Methodical with the ground and pound. Moves him away from the fence. That's wise from Funky Ben. So many options from this position. Look how he postures up. Look how he's looking for the opening. Kadestam covers up. Double forearms guard. Punches raining down on the hapless Swede at the moment.
He's trying to push away the hips. He's trying to slide Ben down his body so he can get his legs out. But now his legs are trapped and he can't go anywhere.
Askren showing patience, not overextending, not blowing himself out early. Beautiful right hand to the orbital there of Kadestam. How does Kadestam get out of this bothersome situation?
He tried to do it. He tried to push Ben down his body, but he couldn't get away. Ben just floats around from position to position. Now he's given up his back. He just can't stay there because he's just going to get beat up.
And indeed, that is what's happening to a hapless Zebaztian Kadestam. Gives his back now to Ben Askren. It could be the beginning of the end for the Swede. Askren raining down the right hands. There's the left. Kadestam forced to cover up. Still Askren in the mound. He's been there for a long, long time, the champion. This is what Askren does. This is why he's so dominant. This is why he's beaten all the big names so far that he's faced. And it looks like he may add Zebaztian Kadestam to the list. Can Kadestam even see out the first round? Askren has his back again.
I like the idea of him giving up his back because Askren's not really known for rear naked chokes. You know, maybe he can create a scramble, but Ben is just, look how his pressure on those hips are. It's so deep.
Has the back again, flattens him out like a pancake. Askren continues to attack. Yuji Shimada right on top of the action here. He wants more action from Kadestam. The Swede trying to scoot back towards the fence, trying to find a way back to his feet. Maybe hoping to wall walk here. Askren keeps him on his back. Still in full mount, Funky Ben Askren. He's had the mount for most of the round. Hammer fist strikes again. Yuji Shimada asking Kadestam, does he give up? Askren unloading here. Over and over again. Kadestam, no place to go. Is Askren going to finish him with 30 seconds remaining in the first round? Kadestam's got to get back to his feet, but he's flattened out again. And Askren thinking to himself, what more do I need to do? I've thrown everything at this Swede. How tough is Kadestam? How is he still surviving? Askren dropping elbows now. Still in full mount, the American. Kadestam taking blow after blow. More blows than a box of Kleenex. Zebaztian Kadestam may see out the first round. He does see out the first round. They'll start from a standing position. It may be the only chance that Kadestam has.
That was the story. Once this fight went to the ground, it was all Ben Askren. Big takedown, controlled and dominated this pretty much the entire round. But then, did you see the way that he was holding his hand? He wrapped his Kadestam's own arm around his neck, pinned him there, and was just unloading on him. That's gotta be demoralizing, just to be pounded on it. It's like fighting your dad in a wrestling match. You're just not doing anything. Rich, how do you have it?
Well, obviously we have been ahead on the scorecards. There's no question about that. But I'll say this, I was most impressed with Ben in that round, how patient he was on the top. He wasn't gonna wear himself out. He chose his shots very intelligently. And one other thing that I really appreciate that he added to his arsenal was when he initiated that first clinch, he actually landed a couple right hands there. Some new tools. Obviously he's ahead on the scorecards.
Sellout crowd in Shanghai for one championship. Wherever you're watching in 128 countries, we hope you're enjoying our main event. Ben Askren will look for a takedown. Kadestam needs to find the target with his striking. Right hand down the tube there from Askren. Backs up Kadestam. Kadestam must keep moving. He told us yesterday the game plan was to stick and move, but he has taken down. And Askren inside control. Will he go knee or belly? Reins in the right hand, not where Kadestam wanted to be in the opening 30 seconds. Now Askren looks for knee on belly, and Kadestam blocks it, Mitch.
Yeah, he's doing a good defense here. He's got his knee trying to block Ben Askren from passing it to mount, but now he's going to go immediately. As soon as Ben tries to go knee on belly, Kadestam's getting that left leg up to block and defend it. But Ben Askren loves to stay inside control. This is where he just punishes.
Oh, look at the chamber of those knees! That leg went so high, I heard organs playing. Ben Askren straight back on top of Kadestam, gets the mount again. He had the mount for a long time in the opening round, Mitch.
And this is probably going to be where the rest of this contest takes place. He gets so deep into his mount, and he's got his body pinned, locked into position, and just starts unloading on you.
Askren said the contest would end late in the first round or middle of the second round by TKO ground and pound. Here comes the ground and pound again. There's a knee drilled to the side of the head. Askren hooks the leg as he did in the opening round. All over him, dominance, technical superiority in every aspect. The wrestling of Ben Askren is just sublime. A martial artist at the peak of his powers is Funky Ben Askren.
Yep.
And he drills the knee again.
Yep.
This is a one-man show. This is one man doing what he does best. And Ben Askren totally dominating. Sign the pink slips, sign the ownership papers. Kadestam may have thought there was a glimmer of hope, but immediately extinguishes that flame, does Ben Askren. But don't forget, Sabo was demolishing Kadestam, and he came back in the third round, Mitch. He's always got that puncher's chance.
Yeah, but this is a total different level of domination. As Kadestam was trying to get up, Ben grabbed his leg, pulled it behind his own back, and then just threw him to the ground. This is domination on a totally different level than what he was doing before, because not only is he controlling every aspect of this contest, but he's beating him up every single chance he gets.
I don't know if in the history of one championship we have seen an athlete get as completely dominated as we are seeing Kadestam at the moment at the merciless hands of Funky Ben Askren. Full mounts again for the champion. The untouchable champion. The unbeatable champion. Askren looking up to Yuji Shimada. Maybe hoping Shimada will stop it and save Kadestam. Puts him out yet again. And now he's going to sink the choke. Is this the beginning of the end? Is Ben Askren going to retain the world championship? And still, somehow, Zebaztian survives. The Swede is still here. I don't know how. Askren wants to flatten him out, and he does once more. Zebaztian Kadestam is at Ben Askren's will. He's at Ben Askren's mercy. Shimada asks Kadestam, do you want to quit? Do you want to give up? Do you want to wave the white flag? And still, the Swede won't surrender. He won't go quietly into the night. And Askren's going to continue to ground and pound. And now, Yuji Shimada stops it. Ben Askren smiles. And without raising a sweat, the champion retains the belt.
That was all Ben Askren. Classic, funky style wrestling and grounded pound. He dictated every single portion of this bout. Once he got the takedown, it was academic. Beat up in every single position. Look at this, he just finds his range. Beautiful duck under, double leg takedown. Into side mount, just gets the back and just beats up the warrior, Kadestam. He hung in there. He didn't give up any easy submissions. He didn't tap out. He stood in there with the world's greatest welterweight. And did he put up a good fight?
No matter the martial art, whether it be kung fu, whether it be karate, whether it be Muay Thai, whether it be boxing, to see an athlete at the peak of their martial arts power is a treat. It's exquisite. And once again tonight, we have seen the champion, Funky Ben Askren, at the peak of his wrestling power, the peak of his dominance. Let's go now to Dominic Lau to enter this one into the annals of history.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Yuji Shimada, has put a stop to this contest after 4 minutes and 9 seconds in the second round. For your winner, by way of referee stoppage due to strikes, and still one welterweight world champion, Ben Askren!